Hello everybody, today I'm here at my 2002 Vitromex Marathon. I'm gonna give it a flush, but it's gonna be flushing as a side little flusher. It kind of reminds me of a space saver, but that did not have quite of a good flush. So I'm gonna leave the main jet plug. Like, what I like about these things, they're so easy to siphon out. Just watch, I have all this, and just on this little bowl, I watch. See, that was pretty cool. That's what I really like about these, because they're so easy to siphon. Well, anyway, there's the Vitromex logo. And I have this on the Elder tank because I don't have the original tank. It's at my house right now, but this tank works perfect for it. It fits perfect. I don't know. I may get some washcloths or something later, and I may see how it does on at least a washcloth with this tank, because if I could, I actually could just leave it on this Elder tank, because I think it's pretty good on the Elder tank. So the next video will probably be of my Round Bowl American Standard Colony, because I think I like this one more than my elongated one, because this one has more of a swirly flush, but it does have hard time siphoning out. But that elongated one I don't like, but I got it from my restore. But I don't want to punish it, because for one reason. But I use mine at my grandmother's, and it doesn't really do good on paper. I'm not a fan of the 2000s. They just weren't the best American Standard Toast design, and the tanks that we're filling. Here we go. It almost did a triple flush there, but that's really what I like about these toilets. Is one, they really have powerful flushes, but I honestly think these toilets would do good on 3.5 gallons, which this is on 1.6, I'm pretty sure. It could be 3.5 gallons, but it for sure takes all these little big foam balls pretty well, which I'm surprised. Some models will be bad. Some models will perform bad. Some models will perform good. So here is my elongated American Standard Colony. I really don't like the design of the trapway opening itself, because American Standard seems to never do perfect with these designs, because they usually, every single colony, they would have something defective. Like, you see that right there? That's a little defective part there. So, tank is full. Here we go. Yeah, see, you can see inside that it has some minerals in here, but I like the design on this toilet, and the trapway is fully glazed too. So yeah, the helicopters are bad. So sorry. I might see how it does on these foam balls on that mark of waterline rust. Something must have got, yep, a foam ball got stuck in the trackway. I'm not surprised that it kind of clogged there. And I have one little jet block, which is the front jet, which makes the bowl go. So I like the flush on this little low bowl line. Let's here we go. Well, it just filled up the bowl, so. Here I might put like three of these little foam balls and wait for it to fill up. I'll wait for it to go on that little wooded water line. So it should be full now. Yeah, here we go. So yeah, I really do like this. I like that because I got it. This toilet wasn't really in the road. It was really in a pile of garbage. It was really in a pile of garbage in someone's yard. So I went and the person was home, but luckily they didn't come out. I quickly grabbed the bowl, put it in my brother's truck, and then I quickly went grabbed the tank. I don't know if the tank lid was there, but I didn't want to get caught. I quickly grabbed the tank and we just drove off like nothing happened. So yeah, that's really the story how I got this toilet. So I might do one more overfilled tank with that seat down. But I really don't know how these things do on normal use. I've never used one of these before. Like I've never used one of these, but I've seen these in person before. I've seen two of the. I like the comfort height and the elongated ones more. I really do like the elongated ones. So honestly, in the neighborhood I got this, I guess probably a lot of houses may have these because I saw a house that was getting renovated and they had two standard height elongated ones underneath the carport, but I couldn't get them. So here's an overfilled tank. Yeah, so that was quite well. So I'm gonna let the tank fill one more time. So yeah, I don't know what toilet I might do next. I may do this one. This is my God. I didn't know how much wax was still in. This is my American Standard Hydra. If you know that one, you've been seeing. I always put in a flushometer. Over there's my Sterling window. I might flush my Sterling Windham next because it's actually been a while since I flushed that toilet. So I might flush my Sterling Windham next. So yeah, I really, really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If y'all did, please like, comment, subscribe. And I will see y'all in the next one. Bye.